Well, going into week five, the AFC North was the only division in football where every team had at least two wins. Both the 2-2 Browns and 3-1 Ravens had byes today. The Bengals and Steelers look to grab their third wins of the year. Andy Dalton and Cincy on the road at Jacksonville, trailing in the second. The rookie fakes and scrambles to his right before rifling a pass to Jermaine Grisham, his favorite target so far this year, tying things up at 13. Now trailing in the fourth, going for it on fourth down. Guess what? Dalton finds Grisham again, who makes a nice catch to keep the drive alive. A few plays later on third down, inside handoff to Bernard Scott. He takes it in for the score. Bengals take a 23-20 lead. Jags trying to respond, but the snap is going to go by rookie Blaine Gabbert. Cincinnati recovers and they go on to win 30-20. They move to 3-2. Very surprising. Steelers hosting the Titans. Ben Roethlisberger recovering from a sprained left foot. And you could hardly tell. In the first, he hits Heath Miller for the tight end's first touchdown of the season. In the second, he's going to find Hines Ward from about 7 yards out. The duo would hook up again in the third quarter. Now we go to the fourth, game already in hand. Why not throw it up to Mike Wallace? Not the 60 minutes guy, the football player, 40-yard pass. 5 TD passes for the Finley alum, tying a team record which he already shared, and the Steelers get back in the win column, 38-17.
I'm not the only guy playing with injury, you know, so I'm not going to complain about it. I'm going to go out and do my best. I think more impressively and more important is how the guys that stepped up and filled in for people played. I don't think I have enough time to name all the guys. There's just so many, but I'm so proud of them.
Eric Page broke the school record for career receptions yesterday. He also racked up 108 yards in punt returns for the UT Rockets, 85 of which came on a second quarter return for touchdown. Because of the efforts, the Springfield alum has been named National Punt Returner of the Week by College Football Performance Awards. So congratulations to him. The top 25 polls are out, and the Michigan Wolverines have moved their way into the top 10 of the USA Today Coaches Poll. Following a 42-24 win at Northwestern, the Maize and Blue are sitting right at number 10, and in the AP, they also moved up one spot to number 11. Wisconsin, still the highest-ranked Big Ten team at number 4 in both polls. Down in Columbus, well, things not going so well, but they are hoping to get DeVier Posey back for more than just the last two games of the season. Attorney Larry James has made records available to the Associated Press, which he believes the NCAA did not consider when suspending Posey an additional 5 games for taking too much money at his summer job. Boom Heron, Marcus Hall, and Melvin Fellows were held out of yesterday's game because of the same violation. They'll return on Saturday. Posey won't be eligible until November 19th versus Penn State, and of course, the following week against Michigan. Well, we'll have to wait another day to see game 2 of the ALCS. Because of poor conditions, the game was postponed until tomorrow at 4. Now, one of the players we won't see in action is Maglio Ordonez, who is out the rest of the postseason due to an ankle injury, which he suffered last night. NLCS, however, was going on today. Game 1, Cardinals at Brewers, St. Louis trailing 2-1 when David Freese connects to right field. It's high, it's long, it's gone. 4-2, Cardinals. 5-4 now in the fifth when Prince Fielder drops a bomb on St. Louis, a 2-run homer, part of a 6-run inning, and the Brew Crew, our Brew Crew, Hubert, right, take game 1, 9-6, game 2 tomorrow at 8:05. And finally, the Sprint Cup Hollywood Casino 400 from Kansas, Jimmy Johnson passing Kurt Busch with 40 laps left to retake the lead he lost earlier. 3 laps left, you're on board with Jeff Gordon, who blew an engine. His day would be done after that, and after the caution, Johnson pulls away from Casey Kane and Brad Keselowski to take the checkered flag. And I say our Brew Crew, Hubert, because us two, we went out on a limb.
Yeah.
We picked the Brewers. They rarely make the postseason. But, of course, we're rooting for the Tigers as well, and we're going to be up there this week.
Air high five.
There we go.
You know, I don't know a whole lot about NASCAR, but every week it's either Jeff Gordon, Kyle Busch, Jimmy Johnson.
Yeah.
I mean,
Kurt Busch.
Carl Edwards.
Yeah.
You never hear any other names.
A lot of good names. Jimmy Johnson looking to get the title once again.
All right, we'll have a final word for you after this short timeout.